Good evening and welcome. My name is Jonathan Swartz. I'm the Artistic Director for Madeline Island Chamber Music, a program of MacPhail. Our program occurs during the summer in the beautiful setting of Madeline Island, and it attracts many of the top music students from around the country. The artists you're going to hear this evening, the Ivalas Quartet, are currently the Graduate Quartet in Residence at the Julliard School. And they served in our program this summer as our Emerging Artist Quartet in Residence. In this role, they not only got to study with our amazing faculty, but they got to work alongside them in our mentor teaching program, learning and getting experience coaching chamber music with many of our high school students. We invited the Ivalas Quartet to MacPhail for a week-long residency. And all week, they have been working with different constituencies at MacPhail, and they've been out in the community doing residency activities that include performances, composers' reading sessions, lecture demonstrations, master classes. They have worked with every age group from preschool through adult education. And the number of high schools that they've visited is too many for me to count for you right now. But all told, it has been a very thorough and comprehensive residency, and it culminates in this evening's performance. The Emerging Artist Quartet and Resident experience for this group was made possible by a very generous donation from Bob and Carolyn Nelson, and so we're very appreciative to their continued support, and we look forward to having more of these experiences during the summer and at MacPhail throughout the year. I thank you for joining us this evening, and I hope you enjoy the program.
Thank you all so much for joining us this evening. We've had a fantastic time here in the Twin Cities. A huge thank you to MacPhail for having us, to Bob and Carolyn Nelson for sponsoring us. And we've just had such an amazing time here working with the students, and it's great to play for you all. We have such a great audience here tonight, which, you know, this city, these cities have such a great art support, so it's great to see it. Just a little bit about the program. You've got some notes, but we wanted to speak a little bit. The piece you just heard was Oswaldo Golijov's Tenebrae, and he actually wrote this piece after visiting the New York City Planetarium with his son, where he witnessed his son's awe at seeing the Earth as a tiny blue dot on the planetarium ceiling. So it's almost as if you're in a spaceship floating, orbiting the Earth, but he also composed it so it could be listened to from different perspectives. And there's always an undercurrent of, what would you say?
Tension.
And yeah, so you can hear that throughout in the viola line and then also in the middle. Our second violinist, Tiani, will be joining us in a second. One thing that's kind of funny about this is she has to tune her G string down to an E for that piece, so she's tuning it back up now. And that's called scordatura. So, yes, welcome Tiani back to the stage. Now that we're all here, we're the Ivalas Quartet. I'm Reuben, this is Tiani, Pedro, and Aimée. And so I mentioned that about the Golijov because the theme of our program is that all of the pieces actually have a connection to outer space. So the planetarium. And I'll let Aimée talk a little bit about how the Beethoven, the piece on the second half, connected.
Yeah, so this Beethoven is one of the cornerstones of the string quartet repertoire. It's one of the most beautiful pieces. It's a late Beethoven quartet. For those scholars in the audience might know that the Beethoven quartets are split up between the early quartets, the middle quartets, and the late quartets. And the late ones are particularly amazing because of his decline in hearing. He was pretty much deaf by when he composed Opus 127 around the Ninth Symphony time, and then he was definitely had no hearing left when he composed what we're going to play for you at the end of this program. One of the most beautiful movements of all mankind, apparently so, because we put it in the Voyager 1 and 2, went up into the atmosphere and took with it a golden record in which we decided to put the cavatina from this movement, from this work. This is particularly special for me. My grandmother was one of the illustrators and technical illustrators and engineers who worked on Voyagers 1 and 2 and Galileo and a couple other NASA projects. As I grew up in Pasadena in California, and with her as a kind of shining light in what was a man's world back then, it's just a really powerful moment for me, and I definitely go there whenever we play this cavatina. So I think that's all I have. I'd like my friend Pedro to introduce the next piece for you. We're going to be playing the Beethoven after the intermission.
So String Quartet number 1 by Eleanor Alberga. She's a Jamaican composer who resides and works in the UK currently. This is a wonderful piece. We're very excited to play it for you. You probably haven't heard it before, although it was composed in 1993. The work is divided in three movements in which we like to think that the first movement works as the Big Bang. It's chaotic, it's crazy, and very, very much unstable. It definitely feels unstable. The work is introduced as a fugue, although it's not quite, it doesn't quite sound like a fugue. Can you guys just play the beginning, just so? Each instrument, it's like coming in one after the other, just like you would in a fugue, but it doesn't sound at all like it has a subject. So that it keeps evolving, and it's completely chaotic to at the point of the ending. The second movement, we like to imagine that we're floating out there in space after the Big Bang, and you can hear the stillness of space, and at the same time, I hear what I like to call solar winds. That it will be sounding a little bit like this. So you can hear that. And then in the last movement, we like to think here in our group that it's just that last movement represents the energy in all living things and in all the things that conform our world. As you know, I'm holding a cello, but this cello is made out of a bunch of atoms, but we don't see the atoms. So it's funny because she writes these beautiful, when we put them together, they are a gesture, but when heard individually, these scales make almost no sense. Can you play one of your scales? Right, so you don't really hear as a scale, and like if you were to hear each note individually, it would make no sense, but put together, it creates a gesture, just like the atoms in this instrument. Another cool thing about the music of Eleanor Alberga, really quick, I know I've been talking for a little bit, is that you can almost always hear her influence from Caribbean rhythms. Nice. But then she also introduces academic writing that makes it sound a little bit wonky. But if you pay attention, you will always hear that underlying folky feel. Great, can we put it together just to see what that sounds like? So it's fun. Through the quartet, you'll hear some snippets of that influence. This is Eleanor Alberga's String Quartet number 1. We hope you guys enjoy it. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
much to see so many people here wanting to listen to a lot of music on a Saturday night. We know there's so many other things you could do, so we're really glad you're here. We just wanted to take this time again to just really extend our like deepest thank yous to MacPhail. You guys, all of you at MacPhail, Dale and all of everyone on the team, there's a bajillion of you. thank you so much for making this week just so, all we had to do was come here and play music. Everything else was taken care of, and that was just it. You guys make our job so much fun and so easy, and thank you so much. And thank you to Jonathan Swartz for all of your, he's out here somewhere, for all of your help with Madeline Island and just being here to support us. I mean, you've come a long way for this week, so thank you. We thought that we would end the concert with one final short little piece. So this week, as you guys probably know, we were doing a lot of things. We went to a bunch of schools from preschool all the way up through high school. We met a bunch of students and we were able to work alongside the New Horizon Orchestra. We got to meet, if any of you were out here, we had a blast in that rehearsal with Eleanor Rigby. That was so fun. But one of the things that we did, actually the first night we were here, we had a composition read through for some of the composer students here in MacPhail. And it was such a treat for us to be able to play through 9 or 10 really amazing short pieces and get to see some of the composers either in person or on Zoom and to be able to workshop those pieces. So we thought it'd be great to end the program with one of those composer pieces. It's really fitting with our program and we hope you enjoy. Thank you so much again for this whole week. And it's, yes, so the reason why, thank you. This is why we're a group and we're a team. So the reason why we're playing this piece, it's called To the End of the Universe, to close out our space program and our residency here in MacPhail and Minneapolis. Thank you so much.
Bye, Carla.
Bye, Carla. End of the Universe by Carl Lexvold.